One of the things that I hear from people up and down the coast when we talk about wind power is that they're worried about environmental impacts. They want to know whether, you know, this is going to hurt birds and bats.
And there's a lot of different ecosystems and species that are potentially impacted. So bats may or may not be impacted. Seabirds, songbirds, whales, fish.
But for me, it's a question of, you know, what effects are people and human development having on wildlife, and how do we try to minimize those impacts?
It's the same that if you put something up in the water out in the offshore areas, you're going to have three hazards really to birds. One is collision. That's the obvious thing. The birds are going to fly into either the superstructure or the revolving rotors. And clearly, you know, if they're going to be mortally injured or killed by this, this is going to add to normal mortality.
Terns during chick rearing are much more likely to collide with power lines because they cut corners, to be quite blunt. The pressures on them to get food back to the chicks outweighs anything else.
And there is sort of displacement effects where animals move away from wind farms and then maybe aren't feeding in the areas where they used to be able to feed.
Visual disturbance is going to scare those birds away, so they're going to be reticent to come close to the turbines. And obviously, if that effect is too powerful, they won't even come in amongst the turbines because they'll be too wary of these areas. So if you like, there's effective habitat loss. It's not that that habitat's been destroyed or the food supply is gone. It's still there, but it's inaccessible to the birds because of their behavioural response, their fear of the turbines.
So what they found with loons is they just avoid these areas altogether. So now you're displacing them, and now they have to move to different areas. Well, now those are suboptimal habitats, because if they were ideal, loons would have been there in the first place. So, and now the question is, how are these suboptimal habitats impacting loons in the long term?
And if it's a temporary displacement, how temporary, how adequately can the resource elsewhere sustain those birds?
Offshore wind farms are, I think, in the first place, obstacles. And they can have a strong, what we call barrier effect. They simply may just be in the way. Arctic terns traveling an average of 70,000 kilometres in a year, you know, and if you have to use up extra energy to go around wind farms, I think that could actually have quite a big effect in the long run.
I do worry about the cumulative effects of putting lots of these wind farms in our waters, because we're not really aware at the moment just how much of a cumulative effect there is on birds. You know, we can often predict with great accuracy what's going to happen with one or two of these put on out in the sea, how they're going to affect particular populations. But what if there's 60 of these things from poor old Ida that's flying from the Wadden Sea in Denmark up to the breeding areas in Finland? One or two might be all right, but 60, well, by the time it gets home, it's going to be exhausted.
You know, so we really want to be careful in how we develop offshore, because we could simply unravel, you know, something in the ecosystem that comes back to bite us.
There's no question we need to look at alternative sources of energy. So we can't continue with the coal and oil consumption. It's not sustainable. Deleterious effects to the environment. Okay, so we have to look at other things. So wind energy, geothermal, definitely good alternatives. And all I think some of the scientists are saying is, can we minimize the loss to, you know, animals? Can we show an environmental ethic?
Yes, we all envisage that we want to see more renewable energy. But in some respects, it's beholden on this industry to demonstrate that it is possible to develop wind energy responsibly.
Yes, I think generally the public are very unwilling to kill large numbers of birds just to have renewable energy. That's not really what it's about. We want benign renewable energy that's going to do a power of good for saving the planet, but doesn't do too much of a damage to local nature.
That we want to ensure that these developments take place with minimum, what we would see as unnecessary, damage to these species. It's not a case of either or, it's a case of getting the best win-wins.